2024, and if you're not taking your health and fitness seriously, this might be the ideal wake-up call. After all that time spent at home during the lockdowns over the past few years, the one lesson learned is that we need to focus on our health and fitness. Now, the good news is that big tech companies, especially Apple and Google, are also focusing on making the hardware and software to make your life a whole lot healthier. I have on my wrist two of the ideal fitness and health companions that we think here on Tech Today might make your life a whole lot better. This is the new Pixel Watch by Google. This is the Apple Watch Ultra 2. Very similar in terms of the health and fitness features coming with the Apple Watch Series 10. What our objective is to tell you what's the best health and fitness companion for you in 2024. Now, both watches have plenty of features, dedicated health sensors on each of them. There's some features that the Google has that Apple doesn't. I'm gonna give you the absolute lowdown. Let's start off with fitness. The Pixel Watch relies on Fitbit, the company that Google acquired, as its companion app to showcase all the health and fitness data. It's free to use, but it also comes with an option of a pro subscription, Fitbit Premium, which you get for 6 months as soon as you buy a new watch. They'll help you with workouts and stuff like that. As soon as you set up your Pixel Watch, you're gonna be able to do that. Fitbit Premium subscribers also get a morning brief, which I found really cool, via the Pixel Watch 3, where each morning you'll receive a summary of your most important health and fitness metrics, including how well you slept, your readiness score, and if any of your vitals are out of range. Now, this is a crucial key feature, especially if you worked out the previous day or not rested enough. It tells you what your body battery is like. Are you ready to take on another day full of all the humdrum in a big city? Or after your workout, are you ready for your next workout? I think this is a key feature. It comes in the garments. We're still awaiting this on the Apple Watch. But the Apple Watch Ultra 2 has Apple's health and fitness apps, which show all sorts of data. These apps are completely free to use within the Apple ecosystem, and they provide detailed insights. If you look at the US market, Apple also has a Fitness Plus subscription with customized workouts and guided meditations, but that service isn't available in India yet. Now, it's no secret that with any of the Apple Watches, at least the last few years, there is a brilliant algorithm with its sensors that detects irregular heart rates, that's arrhythmia, and can also take a fairly accurate ECG. For the longest time, this was the only device which could do that. I think now Samsung's finally got approvals in some markets around the world. But in terms of accuracy, without any marketing or any sort of sales pitch, the Apple Watch perhaps does the best job. But it's not like Google's gonna be taking that lying down. They now have on the Pixel Watch 3, a feature that we saw at Mountain View, the introduction of loss of pulse detection. This feature combines signals from Pixel Watch 3's heart rate sensors, AI, and signal processing algorithms to detect loss of pulse events. If no heart rate is detected, first the Pixel Watch 3 will run additional sensors and a 20-second countdown to avoid any false alarms. But if the pulse is still undetected after this, the Pixel Watch will send a call to emergency services and share critical information with the operator. Honestly, this can be a potentially life-saving feature in the Pixel Watch 3 and is an attempt by Google which is praiseworthy. Now, this is the sort of tech which is impressive, and it's there with both watches. I think both Google and Apple have worked on hardware and software. Using these features, it can be an absolute game changer for senior citizens or someone with a very active lifestyle, people living on their own, fall detection, crash detection, emergency SOS features. If something, God forbid, was to happen, which the watch, the wearable, the service detected, you will have your emergency contacts or emergency services being called in. I think that is an absolute lifesaver. The Apple Watch Ultra 2 has a special feature. It's also fitted with a loud 86 decibel siren. It's a differentiator even from the standard Apple Watch because that doesn't have this siren. I keep this action button pressed, swipe it, even if I've fallen down. It's giving me an option of emergency call here as well. It's getting louder because I'm out here. And hopefully by now, my lovely team has found me and I have reached safe harbor. So this is a very cool feature on the Apple Watch Ultra 2. I don't know why all wearables don't actually give you this feature. Now, the siren aside, one absolute game changer across the Apple Watch lineup now, and this introduction we saw in Cupertino, is an added feature, which we're waiting for with a software update. It's called Sleep apnea detection, which is even approved by the FDA in the US. It uses the accelerometer to detect breathing interruptions at night, and it will deliver the possible interruption results as watch notifications. The best thing about this, it's also coming to the Series 10 and last year's Series 9 watches. So if you've been snoring whilst you're asleep and it's something that's going undetected, the Apple Watch will come fairly close to detecting it. In fact, it's the only wearable with this, and I think this is a feature that will be a game changer for the Apple Watch. But the Pixel Watch also has some interesting features. A lot Apple can learn from Google and Google can learn from Apple. A daily readiness score that uses algorithms to track and analyze your body's key recovery biometrics like resting heart rate variability, that is a major one, and what your sleep has been like off late. It then gives you a score. All of it is computed, tells you how ready your body is to tackle the day. Similar concept, like I said, to Garmin's body battery feature, which is loved by so many. The Apple Watch doesn't have this feature for now, but I think this is something Apple can possibly do with a software update. I can get used to wearing both watches, but they are very different in terms of the looks and the reactions that they elicit from everyone around you. The Pixel Watch looks like a watch. Whether it's the watch faces, this 45mm circular sort of design makes it look like a watch, which is, if that's what you're going for, you have to understand that then that comes with its restrictions. You're gonna have some of these icons rounded on the edges. It's not going to be like a phone. The Apple Watch is like having a mini iPhone on your wrist. You know, very premium build quality in both of them, but there's a huge difference in form factor. That's something you should also really consider. Now, if you like swimming, both the Pixel Watch and the standard Apple Watch Series 10, Series 9 are perfectly fine. But if you want to take it a step further and go diving, then understand that from all the watches in these big tech ecosystems, only the Apple Watch Ultra is certified for scuba diving. It also has a dedicated depth app, which comes on automatically when the watch is submerged underwater. Even if you're going in the pool for a quick swim, the minute you go down there, it tells you what the depth is like, what the water temperature is like. That is a very nifty feature if you're a water baby. But the Pixel Watch doesn't have any such feature, at least for now. In terms of the ecosystem, let's talk about ecosystems because it's Apple versus Google. The Pixel Watch is really immersed in the Google ecosystem, which means it also doubles up as an on-wrist remote control for other Google devices you might have. Maybe a Google TV, which is quite a cool device to really link up your television with, or Google Nest camera, or even your doorbell. If you want, you can also set up a Pixel Watch with an iPhone using the Wear OS and Fitbit app. And obviously, you can continue working. The functionality won't be the same as using a stock Android Pixel device. But yes, in theory, a Pixel Watch can work on Android. It can also probably work on iOS with some level of efficiency. The Apple Watch is completely drenched in the Apple ecosystem. It only and only connects to iPhones. Now, that's something we've known about. But what about the price? All of this health and fitness must come at a price. The Pixel Watch 3, the 41mm costs 40,000 rupees in India and 44,000 rupees for the bigger 45mm that I'm wearing on my wrist. The Apple Watch Series 10 costs around 46,000-47,000 rupees depending on the scheme you get, but the Ultra 2 is twice that price at nearly 90,000 rupees. Now, if you're talking about which ecosystem you want, that's another argument. But the good news is that both these companies are focusing on health and fitness. And there is an equivalent, a corresponding product on both ends. You have Pixel with a product under 45,000 rupees, and in and around that price, you can also get the standard Apple Watch Series 10. Both are amazing devices, really trying to level up on the health and fitness game. Now, if you're talking about accuracy, we've tested both products. Largely gives you the same metrics, especially when we were working out, when we went for a quick swim. They do give you the same heart rate metrics, but it's about how you portray that information, what the layout is like. That readiness score on the Pixel Watch is amazing. But then the Apple Watch has this very gamified approach to your workouts. If you want your health, all your three rings, health, fitness, all of those rings being depicted on the Apple Watch, then you can do so and share that with your family as well. Keep yourself competing with family and friends, and I think that is a really cool feature. And then I've been reading your DMs and comments, and everyone talks about how the Pixel Watch is in its third edition. It's just 3 years old, whereas Apple's been doing this for 10 years. That's true, but there is a small little disclaimer there. Google acquired Fitbit, which was perhaps one of the best health and fitness tracking companies in terms of wearables. Brilliant layout. I see a lot of people when I'm traveling still wearing Fitbits, a lot of loyalists of the Fitbit brand. Google made that acquisition, and now this is technically Google's Fitbit wearable, which comes with all of that Fitbit data, machine learning, AI. Apple has been building on its own health ecosystem. I think both of them are fantastic contenders. If you truly want to focus on health and fitness, the only options you have from these smartphone manufacturers or the OEMs that you should seriously consider are either the one from Google or, of course, the Apple Watch.